As Pope Francis prepares for his first trip since intestinal surgery, we look back at his visit 5 years ago to Poland. The Holy Father mentioned the visit to Poland during his weekly talk with pilgrims at the Vatican earlier this week. He said the trip inspired him to encourage everyone, especially young people, to carry on the gospel of Christ with courage and enthusiasm to future generations. Joining us now from Rome is Janusz Kotanski, Ambassador of Poland to the Holy See. Mr. Ambassador, thank you so much for joining us and welcome back. Can you share with us your memories about the Holy Father's visit to Poland back in 2016?
What can I say? I remember every day, every hour, because it was just a couple of weeks after I became an ambassador of Poland to the Holy See and presented my credenziale to Holy Father. Then we flew to Krakow, and in Krakow, what I remember most is that His Holiness was opening day after day. He saw about 2 million of young people, mostly Poles, but of course not only Poles, many Italians, people from Eastern, Central Europe. And he said very important words to the young people. You must get off from the sofa. You must help Christ to be seen by all those young people who never heard even about him. And I've noticed that the young people are listening, What was the influence of that World Youth Days in Krakow in 2016? Now, in Poland and in many other European countries, there is a new generation. Generation who is thinking about what to do in life. And I think that Pope Francis openly said that without Jesus Christ, without God, you won't find the good way, the way to become a really human being and a Christian.
What impact did the visit, as well as World Youth Day, have on your country?
Luckily, in Poland, young people, well, most of them, of course, not all of them, do believe in God. As you very well know, we are as a unique nation, not only because of our history, but because of present. And the young people in Poland are really in mind those words of Pope Francis. In many places, they are helping each other during that pandemic, and they are building the civilization of love, like St. John Paul II said, because I really do believe that Pope Francis is making steps in the steps of St. John Paul II in many parts.
Speaking of Poland, of course, St. John Paul II automatically comes to mind. Can you talk about his legacy in your country?
Even the new generation of Poles, young Poles, do not have memories, their own memories about Karol Wojtyła, St. John Paul II. And they are being attacked by many false informations. But still, about 80% of young people think that St. John Paul II was the greatest Pole in the history. And they know that St. John Paul II is the man who destroyed communism without using force, and that he was a man of prayer. We mustn't forget about St. John Paul II, one of the greatest popes in the history of the Catholic Church.
Well, thank you so much for your time today, Mr. Ambassador Janusz Kotanski, Ambassador of Poland to the Holy See. Thank you again.
Thank you. You are always welcome.